ben blij om weer in China te mogen vechten. De publiek daar, de mensen daar zijn vechtliefhebbers. Ze zijn liefdevol voor het, ze hebben liefde voor het gevecht. En ik hoop de publiek te vermaken, de kijkers te vermaken, zoals ik laatst bij in Bangkok deed. Na dat gevecht tegen hem ben ik zelfverzekerd geworden. Ben ik veel harder gaan trainen. Echt veel harder. En dat ik gewoon elke ronde op mijn naam moet zetten. En 100% op ronde gaan. Ik wil de mensen een betere partij laten zien. Ja, wat ik de derde keer is het gewoon dat ik echt laat zien dat ik gewoon veel beter ben dan dat hij is. 5 rondes lang als het moet. 3 minuten. Volop knallen.
Naganogi grappling champion and Tenkai, a WBK tournament champion. Jab there from Tenkai. Can he control and stay center cage? Sung Jongli in the first forced him to the outside. On the ground it was Sung Jongli, but it wasn't there for long. The feet was mostly Tenkai. Guillotine!
He's just got the head there in a front headlock, but he's able to transition up into the triangle. But Tenkai, now he's a little bit slippery. Now that sweat is starting to build up on the body, so it's going to be a little bit harder for, you know, Sung Jung Lee to get good and deep on a lot of these, you know, submission attempts. Big roundhouse kick there. He disguises it so well from the southpaw. There's almost no switch. There's no shuffle at all. He just able to rip that left high kick up beautifully to the side of the head.
Sung Jong Lee has 3 wins by submission. All 3 of those are via heel hook. 2 of them he slapped on the first round. The quickest being 34 seconds of Rufino Monte back in November 2017. January of last year, he slapped a heel hook in the second round. Oh, there you go!
I told you.
How about that?
That left kick comes with 0 setup, and it just starched Sung Jong Lee. Here comes the backflip. Here it comes.
He gets airborne. Tenkai, welcome to ONE Championship.
That was an impressive backflip too. But what was more impressive was that, look at this, no switch, no setup. Sung Jong Lee even caught the kick and he just face plants in the middle of the cage. Welcome to ONE Championship, Tenkai.
Another contender for knockout of the night. Sung Jong Lee doing the chicken dance after a beautiful head kick from newcomer Tenkai of China. My word, he is one to keep an eye on.
Wow,
the bird striking.
We're setting it up over and over again. Started to land it. You can hear the thud even from our commentary booth on every single one of those shots. It was almost academic that one of those kicks was gonna find a home.
Let's go to Tom Lau to make this one all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 14 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Tenkai!
Tenkai, on ONE Championship debut, will take the winner's medal back to Shanghai.
Round number 2 of this featherweight fight.
So Rich Franklin gives the first 5 minutes to Edward Kelly. So let's see how the second round turns out now as we push forward into the 6th minute here.
The tool again, trying to cut off the cage. Explosion of punches by Kelly, neither got through.
Vince O'Toole keeps that guard nice and high, being able to defend most of the hand strikes thrown by Kelly. So he's figured out the distance as far as Edward Kelly's kicks are coming at him, so he's able to evade him as well.
You heard the crowd react. That was a hard outside kick landed by O'Toole. Hard outside kick, slapping, landed by Kelly.
But you saw O'Toole sort of use that push kick as defense. Tremendous power displayed by Edward Kelly from Team Lakai. Here we see the flying knee attempt by Vincent O'Toole, went to the clinch. Eric threw a big right kick, but just connected. Click, click, boom, on the right hook of his own. There's the clinch attempt from Vincent O'Toole. Edward threw a kick followed by a right hook with a, first with a right left hook, then with a big overhand right.
A punch on the ground, but Edward Kelly putting Vincent O'Toole to bed with that powerful right hand.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Robin Liam, director of Mansari Group, Under Armour, Indonesia. And now, after 57 seconds in the second round, your referee, Olivier Cost, has called for your winner by way of knockout, Edward Kelly!
That is a huge victory for Edward Kelly.
Here we go, third and final round of what has been an absolute cracker.
I'm surprised we're seeing a third round, Michael.
This is Ibrahim Albuni. You cannot write him off. And Kebab is in the pocket again. He could compete in a telephone booth. Barbers comes forward, double forearms guard, good right hand to the side of the jaw, goes to the liver again.
That volume that Kebabez throws, it forces his opponents to retreat. They try to move their head, they try to bob and weave, but Kebabez just keeps hitting forward like that. He's constantly attacking, and he knocked the mouth guard out of Albuni.
There were two knockdowns for Kebabez in the second round, three knockdowns in the round, it would have been over. And you see that Kebabez continually attacking the liver, large organ in the upper right portion of the abdomen. It's a highly vascular area. A shot to the liver can be excruciatingly painful. It's about the size of a football. Mostly protected by the ribcage, but still slightly exposed. And if you turn the knuckles up, between the 9th and 10th ribcage, you hit that vagus nerve, and that's what closes the body down on a good liver shot. And you see Kebabez go straight back to that liver. And there's a left hook. Kebabez having to weather another storm against the cage fence here. Got to get off the cage. Goes back to centering. Big outside leg kick from Kebabez. 2 minutes remain. What an absolute classic this has been. Left hook Kebabez. There's a straight right hand. Smack bang between the eyes. Albuni with the jab. Leads the right hand for company. There it is to the breadbasket. Belly button through the back. And again from Albuni. Body shot from Kebabez. Hits Albuni's damaged orbital. And referee Onari calls time. He's going to get a yellow card here, Albuni. Albuni receiving a yellow card from referee Onari. That will impact his perks. We continue here in the third and final. Kebabez, this monster, comes forward. Look how he tries to cut off the movement of Albuni. How he forces Albuni on the outside. He has done for the entire contest.
See, competing in the cage is not something, you know, Kebabez is used to. He's used to cornering people, backing up into the corner and then unloading on him. But this cage is giving Albuni a lot of room to run, but now he's not.
Albuni! somehow he's still standing. Albini's mouth got out again. He could receive a caution here from referee Onari. It's usually a sign of fatigue. And you see Albini takes a breather there. The corner of Gabarbez is screaming out. Albini doesn't want to go on here. He's looking for a way out. But that's not in the nature of Ibrahim Albini. He comes home with a jab too.
For his shot at a one super series belt. Beautiful display of tenacity and toughness and just constant pressure from Tarek Kababez. Look at this, senses the momentary weakness, actually a long weakness from Albini, and just jumped all over him, just landing shots to the body, utilizing those giant hands, really putting the pressure on Albini. Albini was looking for a way out. Tarek Kababez gave him that way out.
What a performance. Tarek Kababez absolutely monstered Ibrahim Albini for three rounds. My word. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
To present the medal for this match, we have Dr. Saint Yolan, Director of Operations, World Lightweight Championship. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Oh, called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 26 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Tarek Kababez!
Tarek Kababez pulls off a shot in the kickboxing world. He says he wants gold around his waist. He gets a winner's medal around his neck, and he'll take back to the Netherlands. Andy Sauer, multiple kickboxing world champion. Godson Clive, multiple Muay Thai world champion. Godson Clive, the southpaw, left of screen, edges forward. Crochet armbands around the biceps of God. Sticks a beautiful jab on the schnoz there of Sauer. Buckled him at the knees. Sauer needs to go to that lead leg, that common peroneal nerve, about four fingers width above the lead knee of Godson Clive. You break down the leg, you'll slow the boxing. Yodson Clive with these 4 ounce gloves is something else. Sauer needs to find the output, the volume, the wall drain, get in, get out, land his shots, work the angle. But not stand flat footed in front of Yodson Clive. Oh, Yod tags him again! There's the left hand! The big come off from Yod! And Sauer down for a second time in this contest. He may not get up. The count's on. It's good night, Irene! Protesting with the referee, but he could not make the count. And Yodson Clay gets his revenge here in Tokyo. Yodson Clay Fairtex in 4 ounce gloves was always going to be an absolute monster.
Wow, he was able to hurt him early with that right side. We were so worried about the left side of Yod that he was starting to connect with the right. He was able to land that stiff leg, wobbled him a bit, but then, we'll see, like I said, when he gets you back against the cage, that's when he's scariest. The left hand finds a home, touches Sauer on the chin. Sauer drops. He wasn't able to answer the count. Some slight protesting, but look at that. Boom, hits him right on the nose, and Sauer goes down. Redemption, Yodson Clay.
That's why Yodson Clay Highway Fairtex is one of the best in the world. And there's another world champion, our own Stamp Fairtex. Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 51 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout, Yodson Clay Highway Fairtex.
Undefeated in 8 years, a 30-plus match winning streak, a
rematch 11 years in the making. And the hero Yotsa Clay Fairtex reigns supreme. Who can stop this man? Who can stop Yotsa Clay Fairtex? Soldier inside the in Bangkok. One championship dreams of gold and main event. The one Super Series Flyweight Kickboxing World title. High kick from Ilias Ennahachi of the Netherlands. Again circling into the power side of Pitbull. Now drops away from it.
Ennahachi's got a beautiful lead leg roundhouse. Zero setup whatsoever. Just whips that leg right up there.
Nice tip in with a shot, then the head kick from Ennahachi off the lead leg. Circles off clockwise, which is the direction he wants to go in against the southpaw stance of Petam.
Petam's going to have to slow down this movement. Start attacking that lead leg of Ennahachi. Slow him down, keep him stationary so he can start to unload on him.
Petam bridging the gap, fires that left hand, that diesel piston. Fake a right hand there from Ennahachi. Petam pulling him forward. Ennahachi not going to take the back. Catch and counter almost there from Ennahachi. Circles on the clockwise. Roundhouse kick, looping left hand from Ennahachi.
The leg is very active from Ennahachi. See, Petam's trying to cut the angles, trying to slow down that movement.
Petam wants to get on the inside, looks for the left hand. That being the powerhouse. Wild right hand there from the Dutchman. On the inside now, body shot from the head. Ennahachi hooks away. The uppercut. Here comes Ilias Ennahachi. Ennahachi pounding away.
Go. I like the punching combinations from Ennahachi. Especially
oh,
that
uppercut. Almost knocks the tie out of his hand. Ilias Ennahachi house on fire with the combination.
A little wobbly, he gets put on his butt right there. The push kick.
Petam did not expect that. Ennahachi, more combinations than a Sudoku puzzle. And referee Onari Braxton. What a round here for Ennahachi. They clinch up and tango back against the circle fence. Looping left hand there from Ilias Ennahachi. The combination work of the Dutchman has been superb in this round. Roundhouse kick from Petam. Ennahachi backs him up for the front kick. The uppercut has been sweet off the right hand of Ennahachi. Body shot goes to the liver. Petam ties him up. Onari breaks them. Final 10 seconds of what's been a stellar round for Ilias Ennahachi. Body, body. Petam goes upstairs and he backs up the Dutchman. What a round! Two down, three to go.
Wow, Ennahachi with that boxing looked absolutely spectacular in the second stanza. Once he closes that distance, drops that foot, and then there's those body shots. Goes up top, body, body, head, and then lands with the uppercut. Huge left hook, sneaking around the guard. Look at all the angles. Look at that uppercut. Just lighting Petam up. Beautiful combination work from the challenger.
Often when you see athletes on the front foot with a head full of steam like that, they forget about the beauty of the uppercut. It becomes a lot about the hooking punches. Not so for Ilias Ennahachi. Amongst the many hooks he threw on the inside, he still had the awareness to pop that uppercut. And they were extraordinary. Third round set for five. Sold out inside the Impact Arena in Bangkok for the main event of One Championship Dreams of Gold. Petam Petam, the Academy defending the Flyweight Kickboxing World title. And Petam rallied. Did not have a good second round.
He's got to slow down Ennahachi. Ennahachi's just operating at a higher gear.
Tango back against the fence. Once again, go. Folks, follow us at One Championship across social media, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Double roundhouse kick there from Petam. Ennahachi.
He's a rubber leg. He goes down. He dropped the chair. to go! He's ready to go! He's ready to go! He's gone! He's gone! He's gone! He's gone! It's good night, Irene! We've got a new world champion! And his name is Ilias Ennahachi!
Ilias Ennahachi, what a tremendous performance! Those knockdowns were absolutely spectacular. Once Ilias Ennahachi has you hurt, he does not let you off the hook, and that he did not. Just let it all go. We saw the beginning of it in the first round when Ennahachi started to unload those multiple shot combinations. But then in the second round, Ilias Ennahachi just teased off on Pendam Pindi Academy. Look at the hooks. That was the one that did it. That left hook had Pendam on wobbly legs, and then he just jumped, and then you can see Pendam crumple down. And then he just did it again, just swarming all over him. The body shot. Oh, you can feel that all the way over here, Michael Cervello. And then he connects with a beautiful hook. Oh, man, what a performance by Ennahachi. Wow!
The seemingly unstoppable Pendam has been stopped. Ennahachi indeed had the complete package. Let's go to Dom now.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 59 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of knockout and new one flyweight kickboxing world champion, Ilias Ennahachi.
Ilias Ennahachi with a victory of epic proportion. We told you that many pundits thought he had all the tools to defeat Pendam, and he proved so tonight.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.